What's up, guys? Andre and Holly here.
Hey, guys.
And we are at Magic Kingdom.
Magic Kingdom.
If you couldn't guess already, Magic Kingdom is our all-time favorite park.
Absolutely.
It's always been number one. But if we have to say Epcot, though, it's coming. It's doing real good for us. It used to be our least favorite.
Right.
But I think Epcot is kind of
growing on us
a little bit. We spent a lot of time at Epcot this trip. So we are at Magic Kingdom, guys. Let me show you the coup de grace of Magic Kingdom for us. It's right here. Here we go. That castle, Main Street USA. It never gets old, does it, Holly?
Never.
I mean, it's a beautiful day today, guys. You know, it was a nice crowd though, but it's gorgeous. Everybody is happy and, you know, enjoying the awesomeness of Magic Kingdom. Man, I tell you, when I'm here, it almost puts you in a whole different frame of mind. You know, the cares of the world is out the door at this place. So
right. That's
why we love Magic Kingdom so much. That's why we always enjoy coming here, because of the feeling that it gives you. Right, Holly?
Absolutely.
So, you know, yeah. And almost, it puts you right back into your childhood. So guys, take a walk with us and just look at Magic Kingdom as we enter into the park today.
Main Street USA is on and popping.
Pop, pop, pop.
Now remember, this time last year, it wasn't even open.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Look at the difference a year makes, guys.
Okay, guys, we are on our way to Tomorrowland, and the People Mover is open again. So we rode it the other day, but I didn't video it, so I thought I would video today. The People Mover, if the line is not too crazy. But I want to say the parks isn't too bad today. I mean, they're not like I thought Friday would be. But nevertheless, it's a beautiful, beautiful day, guys. The park is really nice, like I said. Not too crowded, but let's check out Tomorrowland and see what it's all about. As you can see, the People Mover is moving. Astro Orbiters. So guys, we're going to go on a People Mover in a little bit, but first we're going to bring you guys to the Carousel of Progress. It's one of our cool down rides, right, Holly? When it's a little hot out and we want to cool down, Carousel Progress, you can't go wrong. The line is not too bad for the Carousel Progress, guys. As you can see, not too bad, right?
Not too bad at all. Not that many people here today.
Okay, out of all the scenes, what's your favorite scene on this ride, Holly?
Of course, the one where he's holding up the Niagara Falls fan.
Niagara Falls. I like
it. New York.
That's right.
City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. Millions of people came to see it. And since then, the Carousel of Progress has had more performances than any other stage show in the history of American theater. You know, Walt loved the idea of progress, and he loved the American family.
Shining at the end of every day, there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Yeah, it looks like the Robins are getting ready to celebrate Valentine's Day today. What year is it? Oh, right around the turn of the century. And believe me, things couldn't be any better than they are today. Yes, sir, buildings are towering now as high as 20 stories. And moving pictures flicker up on a big screen. We have almost 8,000 automobiles in this country, and we can travel by train from New York to California in less than 7 days. And I even hear tell about two brothers from North Carolina who are working on some kind of flying contraption. It'll never work. Closer to home, we've now got gas lamps, a telephone, and the latest design in cast iron stoves. And that reservoir keeps 5 gallons of water hot and just 3 buckets of coal. Oh boy, it sure beats chopping wood. And isn't our new ice box a beauty? Look at that, holds 50 pounds of ice. Milk doesn't sour as quick as it used to. And our dog Rover here keeps the water in the drip pan from overflowing. It wasn't too long ago we had to carry water from a well. And thanks to progress, we've got a pump right here in the kitchen. Of course, we keep a bucket of water handy to prime it with. Yes, sir, we've got everything we need to make life easier. Say, Mother, I was reading about a fellow named Tom Edison who's working on an idea for snap-on electric lights.
Electric lights? No more kerosene, no more gas.
Sarah sure gets to the core of the apple.
But we do have this new wash day marvel. Now it takes me only 5 hours to do the wash. Imagine, it used to take 2 days.
Well, that's right, folks. Now Sarah has time for other things
like canning and cleaning the oven.
Yes, dear.
Well, ovens don't just clean themselves, you know.
I know, dear. And they probably never will.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got to get the laundry off the line before it starts raining cats and dogs.
Don't worry, Rover. She didn't mean real dogs. Besides, it's not going to rain today. My lumbago isn't acting up.
I'm not going to say I told you so.
Boy, you're going to come down. All you have to do is put your wash on the line, right? Oh, well, the cistern was low anyway.
Wowee, look at that.
Now, James, I thought I told you to ask my permission before using my new stereoscope. It's not a toy, you know.
Ooh, la la. So that's little Peach and
Twin
and
Hoochie Coochie,
eh, Dad?
Didn't she knock out? She's the star of the New World Fair in St. Louis, and now you put that away before your mother finds it.
Aw, Dad.
You heard me. Well, we have one of those new talking machines. Now, that is something. It plays music right here in our home.
There's a great...
She keeps that thing going all day long. Progress.
Oh, Papa.
Yes, Patricia.
Papa, all these people. I'm indecent.
Don't worry, Patricia. They're friends. That's our teenage daughter. She's getting ready to go to a Valentine's dance across town on one of those new horseless trolleys.
I think it's very romantic you're taking Mother out for Valentine's dinner this evening.
Well, you know what kind of sport I am.
I only hope I have an evening as romantic as yours and mine.
Now, you be home by 9 o'clock, daughter. You hear me?
Yes, Father.
Oh, well, with all this talking, I've worked up quite a thirst. I think I'll take one of those newfangled trolleys down to the drugstore soda fountain and meet the boys for a cold sarsaparilla. I'm sorry, I forgot. We're drinking root beer now. Same kind of thing, different name. Well, that's progress for you. And speaking of progress,
there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream to find the heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Phew, boy, hottest 4th of July we've had in years. We've come a long way, though, since the turn of the century, over 20-some-odd years ago. You know that pilot fella, Charles Lindbergh? He's about to fly a single-wing airplane all the way across the Atlantic. He's never going to make it. And sports stadiums are springing up all over. And boy, nobody hits that old horse hide like that new fella, Babe Ruth. Jazz music is the cat's meow. And there's been ads in the paper for months for a movie starring Al Jolson. And he's going to talk and sing. Oh, boy, I've got to see that. There goes Schwartz in his Huffmobile. He sure loves that horn. You know, in my new Essex, I've got an electric starter. Now I don't have to crank. We can travel from New York to Los Angeles by train in only 3 days. And we've got a house full of new electric. Yes, Sarah. You know, next year I'd like to go as Benedict Arnold.
And wait until you see what I've got planned for the fireworks show tonight.
Rover, don't interrupt while Sarah's interrupting.
And guess who volunteered to choose the music for the program?
I did, Pop. Listen to this.
Oh, it's a nice tune, Jimmy. You know, with our new Crosley radio set, we can get news and big-time entertainment from all over the country, even Pittsburgh.
Folks starting to arrive downtown for a spectacular 4th of July parade and fireworks event.
Oh, Patricia.
Yes, Father?
Better get a move on. The radio says folks are arriving downtown.
Do I really have to go? If my new boyfriend Theodore sees me in this, it'll scare him away.
Well, dear, if that happens, you'll always have that torch you can carry for him.
Father.
Calm down, Rover. I was...
A dream away.
Well, it's another Halloween here in the fabulous 40s. Everything is better than ever now. And we've got some amazing new wonders around the house to prove it. For instance, our refrigerator holds more food and ice cubes. And thanks to our automatic dishwasher, I don't have to dry the dishes anymore after supper. Gives Rover and me more time to enjoy our evening stroll together. Later, boy. Oh, and here's something else that's new. I just heard a new term today on the radio. Fella says, we've got something now called the rat race. Did you ever hear that one? It sure describes my life. I'm involved in something now called commuting. I drive into the city for work all day and then turn right around and drive all the way back. And the highway is crowded with fellow rats doing the same thing.
That's what they call progress, dear.
Yeah, I guess she's right. But we do have television when it works. Gives you something to do after you come home. I kind of like it, you know? Guy named John Cameron Swayze gives us all the news. And then they have all this singing and dancing. A lot of fluff, but it's fun. You know, I predict the day when millions of people will learn Latin and Greek sitting in front of their TV sets.
Are you awake, bitch? Give me my left, give me love.
Ah, yes, the new age of electronic civilization is upon us now. Consistent, at least. Makes a lot of noise and blows fuses.
As I was saying, Dad, I think college is really swell. You should give it a try.
Oh, Patty, are you going to the Halloween party tonight?
Oh, yes. And I'm probably the most of you more anxious by then, since I'm going to bed Dreamboat Wilfred.
Wilfred? What a fun!
He's coming as the Headless Horseman.
It fits.
Come on, Ben. That Clodhopper Howard you're going with is no Rattlejack prize.
Oh, poor Howard. I wonder what they said about me when I was dating Sarah. You're lucky, Rover. You don't have to date. Well, we're caught up in the do-it-yourself craze these days. We're remodeling our basement of something called a rumpus room, and we're looking forward to a few rumpuses, I'll tell you, as long as they don't get out of hand.
John, this papering is getting out of hand. I could use a little help.
Sarah, didn't I set up that clever automatic paint stirring machine for you?
Yes, John, you're a genius. Of course, this will ruin my food mixer. Not that you'd care.
Oh, good old Sarah. Always the last laugh. What happened, Sarah?
Oh. In your progress, that paint mixer of yours just sloshed paint across my room. A room.
How do you like that? I always say if you're going to be married, marry a girl with a sense of humor. Well, it's time to move on. Let's cheer up Sarah by singing our song. Come on, everybody.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. Man has
a dream come true for you and me.
So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow,
just a dream away.
Isn't it a pleasant holiday? Oh, turkey's in the oven, it's peaceful and quiet.
Yes! 300 points, my best score yet.
Well, it was peaceful until Santa brought that new virtual reality space pilot game.
Your turn, Grandma. Let's switch the image over to the TV so the resident flying ace can show you how it works. Now, it's a little tricky. Just use your game glove to fly behind the other guy and blast him with your laser blaster.
Laser blaster? Well, I'll give it a try.
Take a look around, Grandma. You're in the ship.
Feels like I'm really there.
Okay, get ready. You're about to blast off.
Here goes nothing. Whoa.
All right, here it comes.
And we tell him to do.
Great. Tell the refrigerator to bring me a root beer.
Well, it can't quite do that. But I'll show you something it can do. Tree lights 30% brighter.
Oh, that's no big deal. Anybody can do that voice-activated stuff. Watch this. Rover, beep!
John, the oven should respond to your voice commands now. Give it a try.
Oh, okay. Here goes. Temperature to 375.
Temperature increase to 375. Shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow.
There you have it, guys. Carousel of Progress.
Carousel of Progress.
Your favorite scene is the Niagara Falls scene, right, Holly?
Got it.
Okay, guys, it is people mover time. Go Bills. I have to give a plug to my hometown Bills, who will win the Super Bowl this year. Remember, you heard it from me first. Okay, guys, it's people mover time. Let's go. Here we go, Hall.
Ready.
People mover time, guys. There's a line for it.
Surfing.
Oh, you doing a little surf? Bang, 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 bang. Let's see if you can see the progress of Tron. There it is in the distance.
Please step carefully onto the
moon. We'll see it when we get on there.
For your safety.
And enjoy your Grand Circle tour of Tomorrowland. Along the way, you can preview many of the exciting places you'll want to be sure to enjoy today while visiting this land of tomorrow. The people mover is the perfect vehicle for people watching, so keep your eyes peeled. You never know who you might see.
Stopped to get a little lunch and a little air at Pinocchio's villa. And we got some lunch. We got the little flatbread pizza. Let me show you. Looks good. Nice and thin. We also got a nice blue slushy.
Slushy. Nice.
Take a sip, guys. Let me try it first.
I'm going to brain freeze.
It's good.
Is it good?
It's real. Don't get it on your shirt. Guys, and it's a nice cool down because this right here, let me just show you. Right around here is Small World Ride. So when you come inside here, and you can kind of cool off and kind of, you know, get a break from all the heat because it is a warm day out today. So we wanted to try this pizza and see what it tastes like. It looks delicious. Take a bite, guys. Come on, open up. There you go. There you go. I like that. And I like that cheese. Oh, yeah. This cheese tastes good.
Right.
That's not a real big bite. Like I said, my lady always complained about my bite sizes. But it's good. Tell me what you think.
I like it. Very good.
You know what? The cheese got like a creamy taste to it,
right? It does. Right. Very creamy.
I love it.
It's good.
Mm.
And it kind of stands, you know. Nice and crispy on the bottom, so it's good. I like it.
What is this, Pinocchio, what you call it?
Pinocchio Village
Hoss. Have you ever had the pizza here, guys? And also this beautiful
blue slushy.
Good. If you have, leave us a comment, let us know what you think. We're gonna finish eating it. Oh, we're sharing this because we have a light lunch because we have a dinner at where?
Be our guest.
Put your service to the test tonight. We haven't had it there in a while, guys. We did have it for the new menu. We weren't too crazy about it. But like everything, you want to give it a second chance to see because it may be better. Maybe that was just an off day. Holly's steak was a little burnt. Her filet mignon, she had it filet, but she liked it. She didn't want any blood in it, but it was kind of burnt, so, you know, we're gonna
give it another try. give it another go.
Be our guest, guys. We're going to bring you guys along with us. As long as we're not in a dark area, as long as it's like ample lighting,
right.
We're going to bring you guys with us so you can see what we think about our dinner. We're going to take you on a couple more rides with us. We're going to let you go, guys. We're going to finish our lunch. Peace is real good. Well, there you have it, guys. Our day at Magic Kingdom. Listen, thanks for going on a journey with us. We appreciate it. The park is closed up now. It's filing out. We actually did have dinner at Be Our Guest restaurant. And I want to say, I apologize I didn't record, but it was just a little too dark. And but the dinner was phenomenal. It was excellent. We're going to try to put some pictures in to show you guys. But anyway, guys, thanks for going on a journey with us. We appreciate you hanging out with us. Until next time, speak life to your situation. And remember, guys, love always wins. See you later. Take care.